Slowly recovering after devastating floods in the state left more than 370 people dead and 8 lakh people displaced. The state's finance minister is pegging total losses as of now at 25,000 crore rupees. The relief and rescue efforts continue in full swing. The state is embroiled in a war of words with the centre over foreign aid. The United Arab Emirates was just one of the countries that offered to donate money to Kerala. In fact, the UAE offered 700 crore rupees for the relief efforts. The central government has politely declined foreign assistance, saying that it is in line with existing policy. But the Kerala chief minister and the finance minister cite the National Disaster Management Policy, which was passed by the centre in 2016, which allows the centre to accept foreign aid. In fact, the Kerala finance minister called the centre's stand a dog in the manger policy. So is the central government right in not accepting foreign aid? We have with us some of India's top diplomats joining us in a bit. But first up, here's the Union Minister of State for Home Affairs, Kiran Riju, and Kerala's Finance Minister, Thomas Isaac, on this controversy.
There should be no politics on any kind of natural calamities, because foreign aid or our internal aid, everything has to move with a policy.
Now, we didn't ask any government, foreign or inside India, for support. We didn't make a plea. They won voluntarily, seeing the misery in Kerala, made this offer.
We are there from the day one. I have visited the relief camps, all those important places. After that, the Home Minister also visited, and the Prime Minister also did. So we are doing whatever, everything is possible. We have deployed our forces, all our manpower, NDRF, Central Forces, Army. So let us not get into the foreign aid or policy matter.
Central government, instead of studying the issue carefully, given the fact that it was not against the national disaster policy, they should have at least discussed with the state government. Now, without that, it is the centre who has taken a confrontationist line, not we. And we are still, what has our CM said? Our CM has said, well, we will write to the PM, we will appeal to the Prime Minister. That is what we are going to do.
Money, whatever is due to Kerala, has been released. Prime Minister has made an announcement. That is also had been done. Now, whatever is necessary thereafter will be done. I can't talk about the quantum of the money what we have to release, but what is there in the SDRF fund? SDRF money has been already released.
What about NDRF?
NDRF will come only after the visit of the interministerial team. Will come back with a report, and that will go to high-level committee. Then NDRF is given. NDRF money is provided only when SDRF money is used up.
We understand there are limitations of central government. We did not, a statement was made by the CM blaming that you have not given what we asked and ridiculing it. No, we didn't. We understand the constraints, but then don't stand in our way. Hey, you have certain limitations, you can provide money as much as you want. Then why do you hinder somebody else helping Kerala?
Joining us today, two former foreign secretaries, Kanwal, Sibal and Mr. Shashank, and also with us, former ambassadors to several countries, Mr. KC Singh. Gentlemen, appreciate you joining us here on the program. Kanwal, Sibal, if I could start by asking you, the Ministry of External Affairs in its statement has said that in line with existing policy, the government is committed to meeting the requirement for relief and rehabilitation through domestic efforts. But if you look at the National Disaster Management Plan, which has a specific chapter, Chapter 9, on foreign assistance, and this was a plan that was put in place by the Modi government in 2016. It very categorically also does state that the government of India, while it does not issue any appeal for foreign assistance in the wake of a disaster, however, if a national government offers aid voluntarily, the Indian government can decide to accept the same. In light of the magnitude of the disaster in Kerala and the response of the Kerala government and the chief minister saying that UAE, for instance, is not any other country. Keralites have had a significant role in UAE's nation building. Should this offer not be accepted?
Well, you know, who is going to make the judgment? Is it the Kerala government that's going to make the judgment? Or is it the National Disaster Management Authority? And whoever they get their okay from in terms of the government. It's for the central government then to take a view. Prime Minister has visited the area. There is a whole administrative and political structures which are giving constant feedback to the central government about the scale of disaster, what is needed. I'm sure a judgment has been made about the extent of damage and how many resources will the government release. Now, if the government initially has thought that they should offer they should make 600 crores available, this must be based on a rough estimate of what should be needed immediately. But 600 crores does not mean that this is the only money that is being spent. Look at the military effort that has been put in. It's an enormous military effort that has been put in and which costs money. Now, I think the UAE government should have consulted the government in New Delhi before they made an announcement, but maybe they were carried away by whatever it is, since there's a very large Malayali population in the UAE. They wanted to make a gesture to the local population.
Yes.
They went ahead and did this, but I think diplomatically they ought to have been a little more careful and consulted either our embassy there and the central government before they made such an announcement. That is one.
Okay.
The other is that this is an issue of foreign policy. And I feel very, it's very regrettable that the Chief Minister of Kerala and political leaders there are equating the UAE and the central government in terms of assessment of the damage and more particularly the large-heartedness and the largesse of the government. They should have faith in their own government. And if, really speaking, 700 more crores are needed, I'm sure the government will make that available and even more. In these foreign policy matters, there should be discretion. And unfortunately, since it's a non-BJP government in power there, and naturally they want to milk the maximum of political capital out of this by making it appear that the government of New Delhi is insensitive, etc., etc., so that they can maintain their vote banks and everything else. It's very unfortunate that this has allowed to get degenerated into a foreign policy issue, embarrassing both the UAE government and the government of India, which had to turn down this offer by the UAE government. And the UAE has become a very friendly country. We have excellent relations with the UAE. And finally, we have very deliberately, got ourselves out of this aid syndrome.
Right.
That we look at our economy, 2.7 trillion economy and this and that and that. We want to be a regional global power and we are going towards that. And if you look all the reports about India's profile, and we can't handle 700 crores and the floods in Kerala, this is ridiculous. We must rely on our own resources.
We must rely on our own resources. Ambassador Singh, let me come to you with that point. And, our attitude to acceptance of foreign aid has evolved over the last two decades or so. In fact, post the tsunami in 2004, we did put in place an institutional framework, which has then been taken forward with the National Disaster Management Policy in 2016. Given what we've just heard from Kanwal Sibal there, saying that, look, this should have been handled with a little more sensitivity on the part of the UAE and some of the other governments that have offered to provide assistance and aid, that this has now ended up embarrassing not just the Indian government, also these foreign governments.
I largely agree with what Mr. Sibal has said. That's absolutely correct. The only thing I'll add would be that this is not a democratic government, say US extending offer of aid through US aid or one of the institutions. This is a ruling family. Now, you can't have a situation where a population of one state in India or a part of the population is seen as dependent on the generosity and munificence of a ruling family of any of the Gulf kingdoms. Now, that's just not a desirable equation to have. And therefore, it would have been really better for UAE to say, and particularly when the number happened to be optically 100 crores more than what the Union government had given. So I think we had a problem shaping up there, which could have been avoided. But at the same time, it can't be, you take two disasters in US. 2005, you had the Hurricane Katrina. And then you had the BP oil spill in 2010.
Yes.
So there were huge, huge repercussions of those which even US could not handle. So with the kind of disasters you are having because of global warming, because of the unprecedented nature of the consequences, it can't be a permanent policy that will not take any help from anyone.
Yes.
Now, therefore, a quick assessment has to be done to dissipate this impression that Union government has not given enough. Why are they silent? There should be a proper assessment. After all, Kerala is not a foreign country. They should sit down and talk to them.
Yeah.
And by now, they should have devised a kind of consensus on what is the road forward and how union government will defray the funds. Now, if government doesn't have the money, then at some stage they'll have to start collecting the money. After all, during the Bhuj, after the Bhuj earthquake, we did take huge amounts of money from other countries, 10 million odd from US, another 10 million from, you know, individually countries sent packages in kind or in cash, largely in kind. Now, that is an assessment which should be done straight away, so that there is no impression in Kerala that, you know, they are neither being allowed to take the money from someone else, somewhere else, nor the union government is giving it. So I think it's also a management of perceptions which has been handled badly. But we do need a proper coherent policy that it is not a straightaway no to any country to give us assistance. It would depend on the range and the kind of disaster we have, and in what areas we need the assistance, and then take the assistance there.
Absolutely. And you know, as I pointed out, the National Disaster Management Policy does have very clear provisions on accepting foreign assistance as well as accepting multilateral assistance in Chapter 9, which deals with international cooperation. But let me also bring in Mr. Shashank into the conversation. When we talk about perceptions, clearly it looks like this is a situation that has been handled badly. What would you suggest and recommend now as we move forward, sir?
No, I agree with my other two interlocutors that we really need to have better cohesion and cooperation between the central government and the Kerala government or the affected state governments to see how the money has to be spent, what are the technical things which need to be done, and at what pace. I mean, just collecting money or even assistance by way of goods and letting them get stored in the at the airports or in some warehouses will not make much difference. I think what is needed is the immediate relief and then on longer term
rehabilitation.
Rehabilitation and then in future such things should not happen. And already there are a lot of reports available as to why these things could have been prevented earlier, but that needs to be done on a long term basis.
Sure.
As far as UAE is concerned, yes, I mean, we have developed extremely good relations with the UAE. And UAE, maybe because of the kind of system that they have offered it on the basis of the experience that they have, that is government assistance. But the Indians are also trying to set up a new policy on the national disaster relief efforts. So if in 2016 we have tried to change the policies earlier, where we were very sensitive, and we always felt that getting large assistance from foreign governments would only make us more liable to use that assistance effectively, cohesively, which was sometimes very difficult because your first priority is to provide succor and relief to the people concerned.
Right.
Second part is that how the flow of assistance, technical or financial, has to be carried out. And a lot of institutions have to be involved for that.
Sure.
In the meantime, if people are sending their huge amounts of cash or commodities or whatever it is, I mean, there has to be a certain method of dealing with that.
Yes.
I mean, I remember in the past we were talking to French, to the Swiss, to many others for various kinds of preparatory steps needed to be done to train our people, to train, have trained dogs, sniffer dogs, etc.
Yes.
And things of that kind for various situations, whether earthquake or volcano eruptions or whatever it is. But since this is flood relief, here we need to provide immediate assistance to people, and that can be done. I mean, 700 crores may seem to be inadequate at this stage because the total damage is apparently somewhere about 26,000 crores.
Yes.
But the point is that you have to also absorb it and use it for the welfare of the people.